క్లియర్గా కనపడుతుందా అమ్మ బోర్డు? బోర్డు క్లియర్గా కనపడుతుందా? రైట్. సో ఈ సోషల్ పొలిటికల్ ఫిలాసఫీలో వీఆర్ స్టడీయింగ్ డిఫరెంట్ ఐడియల్స్. డిఫరెంట్ ఐడియల్స్ ఏమేమిటి ఆ ఐడియల్స్? ఈక్వాలిటీ చదివాము, వీ హ్యావ్ కంప్లీటెడ్ ఈక్వాలిటీ. అండ్ దెన్ జస్టిస్, అండ్ దెన్ లిబర్టీ, అండ్ దెన్ ఫ్రాటర్నిటీ. దీస్ ఆర్ ది ఫోర్ ఐడియల్స్ దట్ వి ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు స్టడీ ఇన్ సోషల్ పొలిటికల్ ఫిలాసఫీ. We have completed equality, now we are entering into justice. Now coming to justice, it is one of the important socio-political ideals, right? Now coming to justice, different people have referred to it. Plato, for example, in his Republic book name, what is the book name? Republic. In this, he said that a just state, just state. I told you, what is a state? State means what? A government or kingdom. Government or kingdom. So, Plato tried to explain what could be a justified government or kingdom. Okay? So, a just state. And then, coming to Aristotle, who is a disciple of Plato, both of them belong to Greece, he tried to give two kinds of justice. He tried to explain two kinds of justice. One is distributive justice, and then the other one is retributive justice. So Aristotle tried to give two kinds of explanations for justice. We study them a little more, what it means by a just state, or what it means by distributive justice, and what it means by retributive justice. Okay? And in the modern era, that is after 15th century, from 16th century onwards, in the modern era, many revolutions have happened, and motivating force is, justice is the motivating force. Justice is the motivating force for them. You know, first in England, that is British, and then in America, then in France, there were many revolutions. And all those revolutions for them, the motivating force is justice. So, one of the most important ideals social political philosophy is, say, what is the meaning of justice? Meaning of justice. Now, different philosophers try to define justice, and to name a few, we can see that in different times it had different meanings. But it depended upon the socio-political philosophy that was prevailing in those days. For example, if you take Sophists, pre-Socrates era. Now, these Sophists, they believed that justice means the interest of the stronger. The interest of the stronger. Here, in the ancient times, it was might is right. So, poor people who were ruling the country or kingdom, whatever interests were there for them, to serve their interests, the justice was intended, right? The intention of justice was to safeguard the interests of the stronger people in the society. Well, it was, but in the era of pre-Socrates. Right? And then coming to Plato said that moral and ethical element in justice. He tried to create moral and ethical element in justice. Here, what he tried to say is that one has to perform his duties. One means any individual, one has to perform his duties. One has to perform his duties according to his, with all his abilities. With all his abilities. And capacities. Towards the social whole. Means any individual, whoever is living in the society, should perform his duties as per his abilities and capacities. Whatever abilities are there in him or her, or whatever capacities are there in him or her, they should do their duty toward with the full capacity, full, right? For what? For the cause of the social whole, all the society put together. And one more man is there by the name John Rawls. You study him even in your polity, right? He says that justice is fairness. Justice is fairness. So what he meant by this, John Rawls, justice is fairness, we'll study him separately, right? So that's why John Rawls talked about justice. He says that for all social institutions, means whatever institutions are there in the society, for all of them, it is the first value. Justice is the first value. For all of them, what is the first value? Justice. Justice is the first value. So, here what happens? The individuals, whoever are living in the society, they accept social regulation. Individuals accept social regulations or cooperate, or they cooperate unless the conditions on which the society functions